see the screen.
Okay. So, yeah, go ahead, Prabhakar.
It's getting recorded.
AICPA Code of Professional Conduct, right? We have studied that. And now AICPA Code of Conduct is in electronic version. It was converted in 2014. And, I have already, showed you. And you can search whatever you want to do that, right? And moving to rules and regulations. So these are AICPA Code of Professional Conduct rules, wherein these are the rules and these are the application, for public practice, businesses and others. Businesses means who are in the job, and others means unemployed and retired. So these are the rules and, these are the application of, based on the areas where they are working. Public practice is, public practice. You do provide tech services, attached services, consulting services. You are in practice, right? Business means you are in the job. Job, whether in accounting firm or working as an internal auditor or something, right? So you are in the job, like me or somebody else, who is working in big MNCs. So they are there again. They are a CPA, but yes, they should abide with the rules of business. Others, unemployed or retired, so CPA designation is not for one time, this is for entire year, throughout your life. So once you retired, you should abide with the rules and regulation as well. Okay, I'm quickly moving to non-independence rules. So these are member in public practices non-independence rules. So the first one is conflict of interest, directorships and gifts, right? So we have done the questions, and I think once you read the handouts, you will able to answer all those questions. So this is the first rule. And the second rule would be your subordinations of judgment, right? So where you have disagreement with your superior, then what you have to do, you have to just discuss with your superior. If you are still disagree with the answer, then go to super boss. If no resolution, go to the people of the chain. And if you don't find any resolution, then consider quitting the firm or resign the firm as well. Okay, now advocacy, you can't advocate any client wherein you are providing attached services, but yeah, there are a few exceptions as well. And third party service provider, if you outsource anything, then you are responsible for their work as well, and you can outsource only administrative work. There are few general standards which we already talked about that, and you have to follow the accounting principles. So if there would be any departure of accounting principles, then you should mention that accounting principles, why that is departure. Also, non-independence rules, discreditable act means there should not be any act, you should not do any act that will give bad impression to your profession. And it's not talking about you alone, it's talking about entire population, right? So entire CPA population, entire member population. So you should not do any act that should be discreditable in nature, like harassment, discrimination is race, age, sex, and harassment, like the sexual harassment, mental harassment, like that. Also, you can't disclose any CPA exams questions and answer whatever you are receiving, or there are a lot many, right? So in the handouts you'll read that. And fees, right? So other non-independence rules is fees, where you should not receive any contingency fees. And contingency fees means by achieving any result, right, you will take certain percentage, something like that, right? So you should not take any contingency fees. Commission and referral, that is prohibited for a test client, but yes, in some circumstances you can take commission or referral fees, right? So you'll read here as well. Now the another rule is advertisement, advertising and confidentiality, right? So you can't advertise yourself false or misleading. You can't say tax authority mein, my brother-in-law is working, or main aapka ye kaam kara dunga. You can't say like that. You should be reasonable enough while advertising yourself, or while giving while telling to other person or client. And also you should maintain confidentiality for client information. But yes, there are some exceptions, and you need to read those exceptions as well. But as per the Discreditable Act, you should not disclose any confidential information without client permission, right? So there are 16 examples, you know, you should read that example as well. Now, organizations and names, form of organization name, right? So there are few basic rules, right? So you should put your organization name based on the rules and regulation, and that should be permitted by law. Like you can't say XYZ. You should put your name that is permitted by law, like partnership LLP. You could say like XYZ LLP. You could say XYZ Private Limited Company, something like that. Okay. Also, your name should not be misleading, right? So you can't say E&Y to E&Y. You can't say Deloitte to Deloitte Brothers, right? And you can't promote Deloitte. Now, past owners can be included in the name of the firm, like Deloitte. The name of the person Deloitte, he is no more, but still we are using Deloitte, you know, as a public accounting firm. Also, you know, you should not designate yourself member of AICPA until unless all the members are CPA, all the CPAs are member of AICPA, right? And again, firm name. You can choose the firm name, right? If you're merging and if you're doing, then you can choose firm name other way around, right? So you can read these rules. Okay. So